Agents are game changers in generative AI. They are nothing but AI tools that help you perform your task. When it comes to data analysis, Pandas AI Agent is king. Today, we talk about Pandas AI Agent and see how to use it for data analysis step by step. To show this, we'll build an app like this. First, we'll load our dataset. The dataset we'll use is e-commerce customer behavior dataset on Kaggle. Using this dataset, we'll explore customer behavior within an e-commerce platform with an open source model, let's say Llama 3. Here, we'll enter our prompt to talk to our dataset, and then Pandas AI agent will return a response. Cool, right? Let's take a look at the topics we'll handle. First, we'll create a virtual environment and then install the tools we'll use. Next, we'll initialize Llama 3 with Ollama. After that, we'll load the dataset and then we'll build the app. Lastly, we'll chat with the dataset using Pandas AI agent. Nice! We've seen the topics we cover. Let's go ahead and start with the setup. To write our codes, we're gonna use the VS Code editor. Now, let's create a virtual environment. To do this, we're gonna use conda. Let's write conda create-n, let's name gen AI. Let me press enter. I already created this. This is simple, right? After that, we're gonna activate this environment. Conda activate gen AI. Here you go. Our environment is ready to use. The next step we're gonna do is install the tools we'll use. To do this, let's create a requirements.txt file. We're gonna click on the new file and then name it requirements.txt. Okay? After that, let's write the libraries we'll use here. To work with Pandas AI, let's write Pandas and Pandas AI. Next, to build the app, we'll use Streamlit. Let's write Streamlit. For now, these tools are enough to build the app. We're gonna now install this. It's simple to do this with pip. Let's type pip install-r requirements.txt. Let me press enter. Here you go. Our tools are ready to use. To write our code, we're gonna create a Python file. Let me click on the new file and then give a name. app.py. Yeah, our file is ready. So far so good. Let's go ahead and initialize the model with Ollama. When it comes to working with LLMs locally, Ollama is king. This tool allows you to run open source LLMs such as Llama 3 and Mistral. Trust me, it's very easy to use Ollama. All you need to do is download it from the website and then install it your computer. After installing, you can use Ollama in the terminal. Let's start Ollama. To do this, let's write Ollama serve. I already started Ollama. Okay, Ollama is ready to use. You can use many large models with Ollama. Let me show you these models. Let's go to the website and click the models. There you go. Here, you can choose any model you want. It is a piece of cake to load a model with Ollama. To install a model, we're gonna use the terminal. Let me show you. Let's say we wanna install Llama 3. Ollama pull Llama 3. Let me press enter. There you go. As you can see, Llama 3 is loaded. You can see the install models with this command. Ollama list. There you go. As you can see, I loaded many models. The model we'll use is the Llama 3 8B version. Note that to run Llama 3 version 8B locally, your system must have 8GB or 16GB RAM. If you have an Nvidia card, you can get information about your GPU devices with Nvidia-SMI. There you go. I have the RTX 4070 Ti Super Card. The better graphics card you have, the faster you will get an answer. Okay, let's go ahead and initialize the model with Ollama. To do this, we're gonna use the local LLM class. First, let's import this class from pandasai.llm.localllm import the local LLM class. Okay? The first thing we're gonna do now is instantiate an LLM object by specifying the model name. To do this, we're gonna use compatibility. This helps the app to connect to Ollama. Let's write model equals, let's type local LLM. First, let's connect Ollama. To do this, let's set the API base parameter. Let's pass HTTP localhost 11434/version1. Okay. Next, let's specify the model. Model equals, let's give llama 3. Nice. Our model is ready. Let's go ahead and initialize the app with the streamlit. First, let's import this tool. Import streamlit as st. Next, let's give the app a title. St dot. Let's call the title method. Let's pass data analysis with Pandas AI agent. Okay. After that, let's run this app. Let me go to the terminal and then write streamlit run app.py. Let me press enter. Yeah, the app opens automatically in the browser. This is simple, right? You can see the title here. Let's go ahead and create the widget to load the dataset. To do this, we can use the file uploader method. Let's say uploaded file equals sd dot. Now we wanna use a sidebar. Sidebar. And then let's call the file uploader method. File uploader. First, let's give a text. Upload a CSV file. Next, let's specify the file type. Type equals, let's give CSV. Nice, we created a widget. Let's test this widget. To do this, go to the app and then click rerun. There you go. To load the dataset, let's click over here. And then select our dataset. After that, let's click on the open button. Yeah, the file is uploaded. Easy peasy, right? If you want, you can hide the sidebar like this. Let's go ahead and take a look at the first rows of the dataset. To do this, let's use the if statement. Let's write if uploaded file is not none. After that, let's convert data into the pandas data frame. First, we're gonna import pandas. Import pandas as pd. Okay. Next, let's read the dataset. Data equals pd.read.csv. Let's pass uploaded file. Now, let's write the first rows. Sd dot. Let's call the write method. Let's pass data head. Let's give 3. Now, let's test the app. To do this, let's go to the app and then click rerun. There you go. You can see the first rows of the dataset. To analyze this dataset, we're gonna use the Pandas AI agent. To do this, first we're gonna import the agent class. Let's go back VS Code and write from Pandas AI import agent. Okay. Next, let's get an object from this class. Agent equals agent. Let's pass our data. Let's set the config parameter. Let's specify the large model. Let's pass our model. Nice. Our agent is ready. Next, to get the input from the user, let's create a text area. Prompt equals sd.textInput. Let's give a text. Enter your prompt. Okay. Nice. Our text area is ready. The next thing we're gonna do is create a button. For this, let's use the button method with the if statement. If sd.button, let's pass generate. When pressing this button, we wanna run the prompt. If the prompt is true, let's display a message while running the code. To do this, let's use the spinner method using the with keyword. With sd.spinner. Let's give a text generating response. Now All we need to do is return the response. To do this, let's call the write method and then invoke the chat method. For a response, let's pass the prompt. Awesome, our app is ready. Now, it's time to test the app. Let me go to the app and then click rerun. There you go. All we need to do now is write a prompt to chat with the dataset. Hey Pandas AI agent, tell me how many rows and columns are in the dataset. Let me click on the generate button. Yeah, the app is up and running. Voila, here is the response. We got the output by talking to the dataset. Amazing, right? Now we can explore our dataset using this app. First in first, we look at the last three rows of the dataset. Return the last three rows of the dataset. Let me click generate. Yeah, it's done. Here are the last three rows. Try another prompt. For example, give the last three rows of the dataset. Let me click generate again. As you can see, this prompt didn't work. Maybe this prompt will run for you. It's important to keep in mind that if your prompt doesn't work, try another prompt. Let's give another prompt related to this text. Return me the last three rows of the dataset. Let me click generate again. There you go. Note that Pandas AI uses a cache to store the results of previous queries. You can see the cache file here. This file is created automatically. If you run the same prompt, you will quickly get the same result. Let me show you. Here is the same result. Cool, right? Let's go ahead and ask for information about the columns of the dataset. Give information about the columns of the dataset. Let me click generate. There you go. You can see 11 columns of the dataset here. Let's move on and take a look at the missing values. Show how many missing values there are in the dataset. Let me click generate. There you go. The number of missing values is 2. Which column is missing value? Let me click generate. There you go. The app shows the name of the column. This way you can chat with your dataset. Let's go ahead and take a look at the average of the total spent column. To do this, let's write what is the average of the total spent column. Let me click generate. There you go. Here is the average. Let's go ahead and talk about how to plot charts with Pandas AI agent. As you know, visualization is a great technique that helps you understand your dataset. First, let's look at the bar plot of the gender column. Let's write plot a bar chart of the gender column. Let me click generate. There you go. Here, you can see the distribution of the gender column. Easy peasy, right? Note that this chart is saved automatically in the export file. You can see this plot here. Awesome, right? Let's go ahead and plot a pie chart. Draw a pie plot of the city column. All we need to do is click generate. There you go. Here is the city distribution. Let's move on and plot a histogram of the age column. Plot a histogram of the age column. Let me click generate. There you go. Here is the age distribution. Let's go ahead and visualize average age by gender. Let's write draw a bar plot of average age by gender. Let me click generate. There you go. Here are the average ages by gender. Let's go ahead and plot a box chart. Draw a box plot of the age column. As always, let me click generate. There you go. Here is the box plot of the age. Let's take a step forward and plot a box plot of the age column by membership type. Draw a box plot of the age column by membership type. Let me click generate. There you go. Here are the box plots. As you can see, branch members are older. Let's move on and plot a scatter chart. Let's write plot a scatter chart for the age and item purchased. Let me click generate. There you go. Here is the scatter chart. Lastly, we wanna plot a heat map. Plot a heat map chart for numerical variables. Let me click generate. There you go. Here is the heat map chart. There is an inverse relationship between age and other columns. Awesome, right? As I said, to run the large model, you may need to try a few prompts. All we need to do is change your text a little bit. Yeah, that's it. In this video, we covered how to use the Pandas AI agent with Llama 3. To show this, we built an app step by step with Streamlit. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment. See you in the next video. Bye for now.